everyone, and welcome back to Scandinavian Design 101. I'm Sanna.
I'm Andreas, and we are two Swedes, and we love design.
Mm-hmm. And today we're going to talk about something as random as design furniture seen in sci-fi movies.
Yeah.
We will focus mainly on movies that takes place in the future. That is sci-fi for me.
Yeah, but it can could also be like movies taking place today, but with the sci-fi, superheroes and so on. But that's not really the
case. Those are action movies, though.
Yeah, okay. Mm.
Well, we know very little about the future, but one thing is almost certain, and that is that furniture will exist also in the future.
Yes. And when shooting a film that takes place in the future, one can have two different approaches when it comes to scenography and the choice of furniture used. One can decide to design all the furniture from scratch and imagine what the future might come to look like. And this is perhaps the best and most honest approach, especially for movies that takes place in the distant future. I mean, it's not very likely that 20th century furniture would be used on a spaceship in the 24th century. And the second and probably most common approach is to simply use existing furniture looking futuristic. And yeah, it's not very realistic, but hey, we are talking about sci-fi movies, so realistic, yeah, it doesn't really matter.
It doesn't.
And now, let's take a look at some existing design furniture featured in some famous sci-fi movies.
First, I'm going to talk about Men in Black 2. The movie's Men in Black doesn't take place in the future, but includes a lot of funky stuff like aliens, laser guns, and teleportation. That's cool. And also a lot of design furniture. For a Swede interested in design, like we are, one chair is especially interesting, the one featured on the movie poster of Men in Black 2. This egg-shaped creation can easily be recognized as the Ovalia chair designed by the Danish-Swedish designer Henrik Thor-Larsen. It was first exhibited at the Scandinavian Furniture Fair in 1968. The producer was the Swedish company Torlan. The chair itself is quite typical for its time, made from fiberglass with a futuristic look. Some of the Ovalia chairs had integrated lamps and speakers. That's cool.
Yeah, it is.
Henrik Thor-Larsen was probably highly inspired by the ball chair designed by the Finnish designer Eero Arne 2 years earlier. Production was discontinued in 1978, but was started again in 2005, much thanks to Men in Black. But the story is a bit more complicated than one might think. The two chairs featured on the famous movie poster were in fact illegal copies. Back in the days, Thor-Larsen delivered more than 500 chairs to an American retailer who soon started to produce copies without paying the Scandinavian designer any royalties. Back then, Thor-Larsen lacked the money necessary to start a lawsuit, but when he saw the copies used in the Men in Black movies, he immediately contacted Columbia Pictures demanding money. The matter was soon settled and Thor-Larsen was paid an unknown sum of money, but it was big enough to start producing the chair again.
Yeah, it's a fun story.
It's a happy ending.
Yeah, it is. And now let's talk about Star Trek. The legendary TV series Star Trek was first aired between 1966 and 69 on American TV. Much later in Sweden, I guess. We were
probably
much later back in the
days.
I've
never seen it.
No, okay, no. It's a classic.
I know.
But produced by Gene Roddenberry, it displays an optimistic view on the future. And that's rare.
Yeah, it is often rare.
As most of you already know, the plot takes place on the Starship Enterprise, a kind of Art Deco-looking creation exploring space in the 23rd century. And if strolling around on Enterprise, one would find quite a few pieces of design furniture. And best known are probably the white futuristic chairs often claimed to be Tulip chairs by Eero Saarinen. Saarinen designed the Tulip range back in 1956 because he hated the way the legs looked on most dining chairs. A traditional dining table and four chairs has as much as 20 legs. And aesthetically, it wasn't pleasing, according to Saarinen, and cleaning the floor was almost impossible without moving all the furniture. And as a result, he designed the one-legged chair Tulip, and it's said to be the first ever one-legged chair. Today it's not that fantastic, but back in the days it really was. And it's indeed a space-age-looking creation, and absolutely suitable for a spaceship. But let's go back to the starship Enterprise. Did Captain Kirk and his fellow explorers sit on Tulip chairs? And the sad answer is simply, no, they didn't. It's not chairs by Saarinen, but a rip-off created by Maurice Burke in the 1960s, produced by the British furniture company Arkana. And as with the original Tulip chairs, it's made from fiberglass with an aluminum foot. And the biggest difference is the shape of the foot. Instead of a trumpet shape, the Arkana chairs has a propeller-shaped base. Mm. Some of the chairs used at the set of Star Trek was customized. The high-back version seen on the command deck, for example, was a creation of the film crew and never available in the furniture store. And, of course, there's a lot of other design furniture seen in Star Trek, the original series, and definitely also in the movies. One example is the highly futuristic-looking President lounge chair designed by the Danish architect Steen Østergaard in 1968, and they were made for Cado, a company owned by Paul Cadovius, if you heard about him. And another example is the funky-looking ribbon chair designed by the French designer Pierre Paulin, I think it's pronounced, in 1966. And it was produced by the Dutch company Artifort, and it's a great example of 1960s space-age design. So it's good-looking furniture, and they are really suitable for Star Trek, I think.
Next up is 2001, A Space Odyssey.
Yeah.
It's an epic science fiction film produced and directed by Stanley Kubrick in 1968. In the movie, one can see some legendary pieces of furniture. Best known is perhaps the Djinn chair designed by Olivier Mourgue. Mourgue means, no, that's the place where people go when they die.
I'm not sure.
Well, in 1965 for Airborne International.
Yeah.
They can be found in the Space Station 5, a huge wheel-shaped space station orbiting Earth.
Yeah.
Not only the easy chair, but also the sofa were featured in the movie. In the movie, the crew also used cutlery designed by Danish architect Arne Jacobsen to eat when on the Jupiter mission. Arne Jacobsen designed the cutlery already in 1957 for the SAS Royal Hotel in Copenhagen. They were originally produced by the silversmith Michelsens, Sølvsmedje, and today they're being produced by Georg.
Yeah.
They look futuristic and totally different from any other tableware on the market, and therefore it's hardly surprising they were used in the movie. When they were released to the market in the late 50s, the critics loved them and they got much attention at the 1957 Milan Triennale. But the guests at the SAS Hotel were far from impressed, complaining on the low weight of the knife, the short teeth on the fork, and not least the extremely narrow spoon. Due to the many complaints, the cutlery were soon replaced by more traditional, boring ones.
Yeah. And now let's talk about the Alien movies.
Let's do.
That's a favorite. In 2012, the movie Prometheus was released as a part in the Alien saga. And as with the previous movies, it was produced by Ridley Scott. And it is set in the late 21st century, not very long time in the future. And most of the plot takes place on the spaceship Prometheus, traveling on a mission to a distant planet. A chair seen in this movie is the Swedish swivel chair Omni, designed by Carl Öjerstam in 2007 for the company Materia. And The set director Sonja Klaus had seen the chair pictured in the newspaper Evening Standard and immediately realized it would be perfect on the spaceship Prometheus. It looks indeed futuristic, and the combination of chrome metal and white leather feels high-tech, I would say. The chair was used in the private space of Wayland Corporation representative Vickers. Two other chairs seen in the same movie are the Orgone and Gluon, it's a strange names, but designed by Mark Newson. And they can, for example, be seen during the crew's briefing when they find out why they have been sent on the mission. And Orgone, designed by Newson in 1993, was exhibited at his solo exhibition Wormhole at the Milan Furniture Fair the following year.
That's a futuristic name.
Yeah, and I think at least Gluon is some kind of particle in physics, so it's also some kind of space-age thing. And it was an attempt by Newson on working with aluminum in a fluid form, and the organic form almost makes the chair look like if it's a living organism. Mm. I really think so. And Gluon, on the other hand, is a much more functional chair designed by Newson the same year as the other chair. And it's a modular chair possible to combine as desired, and the void in the center acts as an air cushion to make it comfortable to sit in.
Air cushion, huh?
Yeah, that's a fancy name for not designing anything at all.
Yeah, exactly.
And the visible framework gives it a high-tech look suitable for any spaceship, so I can understand why they used it in Alien movies. Another movie in the Alien saga where you can see design furniture is Alien Covenant. It's pronounced Covenant.
I think so.
Released in 2017. And one example is the magnificent Art Nouveau throne chair designed by Carlo Bugatti already in 1905. And it's far from space age, of course, but works perfectly as a contrast against this sterile futuristic backdrop. Mm. And Bugatti was inspired by Japanese and Islamic art, and that can easily be seen in the throne chair. And next to the chair, in this movie, one can spot an E1027 table designed by the legendary Irish designer Eileen Gray in 1927. And made from tempered glass and chrome steel, it's a futuristic looking table, even though it was made for almost 100 years ago.
We should make an episode about her.
Yeah, she's a very fascinating woman.
Very. Last up is Blade Runner. I've not seen that one either.
Oh, you haven't? No, that's a real classic.
Whoops. It was made in 1982 and it's set in a dystopian future Los Angeles of 2019.
Yeah.
Well, that's funny. Well, it's starring Harrison Ford as former policeman Rick Deckard. When creating this dystopian metropolis, the director Ridley Scott again was inspired by the Italian architect Antonio Sant'Elia.
Sant'Elia. Yeah.
Difficult. These languages,
especially languages that you'd never, almost never heard being spoken.
Well, he was a pioneer of the futuristic movement in the early 20th century, but he was also inspired by the industrial landscape of his childhood home in England, as well as Hong Kong on a very bad day. Well, okay. In this dystopian landscape, some well-known design objects were used. One example is the Argyle chair designed in 1897 by the Scottish designer Charles Rennie Mackintosh. The chair is an example of geometric Art Nouveau and has an iconic shape in the backrest. In a way, it almost looks like a throne despite its plain and simple construction. In Blade Runner, the Argyle chair was used in the apartment of the ex-policeman Deckard, Harrison Ford.
Yeah.
In the same apartment, quite a few interesting lamps can also be found. Most iconic is probably the Saturn-shaped glass lamp first created by House Glass Company.
Yeah.
What is that?
Yeah, it's a...
Well, it was for the 1939 World's Fair in New York. It's for sure one of the best Art Deco Space Age lamps ever made.
Yeah.
Interestingly, the same lamp can also be seen in the Red Room in the TV series Twin Peaks.
Yeah, and we love that too.
I don't love Blade Runner. I've not seen it.
No, you haven't. Mm. No, but you should see. We have to look
okay,
at it.
Okay.
Yeah, but the conclusion here, because this was some examples of furniture and lamps seen in different sci-fi movies, and it's interesting to note that there are two different types of furniture often used. And the first type is the most obvious ones, space-age design made from fiberglass, plastic and chrome steel.
Mm-hmm.
And the only odd thing about them is that most of these furniture were designed 50 or 60 years ago. And it's like if our view of what the future might look like hasn't changed for all these years.
Mm.
That's strange.
It is.
But the second type of furniture are perhaps a bit more surprising. And that's older wooden furniture, often inspired by folklore and traditional art. And it's hard to say why they work so well in space movies, but perhaps it has to do with contrast. I mean, and by some reason, furniture by designers like Macintosh feels a bit extraterrestrial almost, like if they could have been made by some alien race on some distant planet.
Yeah.
Yeah, and this was our episode about space age design furniture in the movies.
Hope you enjoyed it.
Yeah, and if you liked the episode, what should you do?
Please click thumbs up and subscribe.
Exactly, and you should also follow us on Instagram. We are called Scandinavian Design 101.
But you do already, huh?
Yeah, you do. Thanks a lot.
Thank you for watching.